Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from group 4 and today we want to share our discussions about the leaf blight in rice plants. So let me introduce you about myself. My name is Sarah Vanessa Andrianisa with student number 131.
Hey, my name is Ogi Prayuga and my student number 121.
And my name is Titan Andrianti, NIM 135.
Hello, my name is Dewi Istiqomah, with student number 137.
My name is Dina Esah Puspita Sariwadani, with student number 138.
And my name is Rinda Sofia, with student number
145. So first of all, the purpose of this discussion is to know the dominance of pathotype XOO on rice plants from various irrigation sources. Next is description of plants. So the host of this topic is the rice plants, and then the disease itself is the leaf blight or hawar daun. And the pathogen is Santomonas oryzae or XOO.
And the next, bacterial leaf blight. Bacterial leaf blight spread in various ecosystem of rice plant and is difficult to control. This disease is caused by the gram-negative bacteria Santomonas oryzae PV, oryzae which produces plague that damage the chlorophyll of leaf and cause a decrease in the ability of plant to carry out photosynthesis. Next, a sign that the plant is affected by leaf blight. Symptoms begin in the form of white spot grains on one or both sides of the leaf, usually starting from a leaf or several centimeters of the leaf. And then, spots then develop extend to the tip and base of the leaf and white.
The sign that the plant is attacked by leaf blight part 2. Number 3. The leaves are grayish green and slightly colored, then dry out and whitish gray. Number 4. On that plant vulnerable, this symptom continue to develop throughout the leaf, become dry and sometimes to the midrib. And next, monitoring of leaf blight in rice plant. Location. Number 1. Kringing rice bed. Condong Catur, Depok District, Sleman Regency, irrigation from Embung Tambak Boyo. Number 2, Purwamartani Rice Bed, irrigation from the Mataram Dis. Number 3, Medomartani Rice Bed, irrigation from stream. Number 4, Berbah Rice Bed, irrigation from the Opak River. And next, Sketsa. The number of sample used was 5 sampling point on each block diagonally were at each point 1 ADB symptoms leaf was taken.
Monitoring of leaf blight in rice plants. Time. Harvest of ultra early rice can be harvested at 90 days afterwards. Rice leaf blight can appear at 35 under 40 days afterwards. Therefore, observations are made at 7 until 12 weeks after planting. And this is data of disease intensity with 4 block repetition and 1 until 6 weeks after planting disease intensity with mean 12% and ODPJ with mean 12%. Disease intensity was obtained based on calculation for 6 weeks after planting. Block 1 comes from irrigation location 1, block 2 comes from irrigation location 2, block 3 comes from irrigation location 3, and block 4 comes from irrigation location 4.
This is cut of disease intensity and the ODPC. The left graph is a graph of the intensity of disease and the right graph is a graph of the ODPC. The pink line shows as intensity of the disease block 1. The light green line shows an intensity of disease block 2. The orange line show an intensity of disease block 3, and the old green line show an intensity of disease block 4. The highest of the disease intensity is in a block 2, and the highest of LDPC is in a 6 week after planting block 2, which is as a big 148%. This is table of the different irrigation system. Composition table of the zoopatotype during the rainy season can we get from for water distribution time. Total number of isolate is 448, and the zoopatotype 3 is 133, zoopatotype 4 is 183, and zoopatotype 8 is 132. Composition table of the zoopatotype during the dry season can we get from 4 water distribution time. Total number of isolate is 154. Zoopatotype 3 is 3, zoopatotype 4 is 82, and zoopatotype 8 is 69.
Okay, the next is conclusion. XOO or Santomonas oryzae patotype 4 consistently dominates areas with irrigation system 1 and 4 in the two growing seasons. In areas with irrigation system 2, there was a shift in dominance from patotype 4 during the rainy seasons to patotype 8 in the dry seasons. Likewise, in areas with irrigation system 3, there was a shift the dominance of patotype 3 in the rainy season become patotype 4 in the dry season. The result of this calculation show that the level of disease severity intensity is 12%. For the next disease control, HBD with resistant varieties based on the suitability between the resistance properties of the variety and the XOO or Santomonas oryzae patotype in the field. In areas with irrigation system 1 and 4, it is recommended to plant rice varieties that are resistant to XOO or Santomonas oryzae patotype 4. Meanwhile, in areas with an irrigation system 2, it is recommended planting rice varieties that are resistant to XOO or Santomonas oryzae patotype 4 and H, while in areas with irrigation system 3, it is recommended to plant rice varieties resistant to XOO or Santomonas oryzae patotype 3 and 4. Okay, this all for today's presentation. Thanks for your attention, and Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.